Peace. This is Shihan Husseini. You can call me who? Addressing you from the Isshinryu India Home Budojo Epicenter. Dear Karatakas, my dear disciples, senseis, and everyone listening to this, my profound love and respects to you. Human beings known as Homo sapiens are becoming completely irrelevant in the massive transformational change that is sweeping the world due to total computerization and the destructive and degenerative wave created by digital algorithms and the looming dangers of catastrophic climate disasters and an accidental nuclear conflict and an unimaginable Holocaust. This lecture is being given after a period of unprecedented crisis due to the killer coronavirus, and it is hoped that this pandemic must not ruin and paralyze the collective human confidence, determination, optimism, faith and will. And it is my strong belief that these lectures will inspire the world with a new awareness of man's indomitable spirit and all-pervasive and persistent personality which can conquer anything. After over half a century of experience in learning karate, over 44 years of teaching Isshinryu karate in India to hundreds of thousands of students, creating over 3,000 black belts, sculpting hundreds of champions in this field, and creating over a dozen human endurance world records in karate, I must say that karate has truly not been properly, fully, correctly, and scientifically explained by any expert, because many proponents of the art have tended to simplify the explanation and description of karate either due to lack of in-depth knowledge or being crippled by the absence of articulate communication skills. While many have made attempts to define karate do in their own intrinsic ways, these explanations are usually false, shallow, or misleading. Having spent an entire lifetime learning, experiencing, and teaching karate do, it is my prime priority and responsibility to finally leave a documented legacy by defining in my own way what karate do truly is. This is for posterity to understand and remember. This is the first of 12 lectures on various aspects of karate do, which will attempt to explain to millions of karatekas all over the world and my disciples the true meaning, principles, philosophy, and the practice of karate do. Hoist to all karatekas, senseis. And again, this is Shihan Husseini, founder and father of Isshinryu Karate in India, addressing you from the Honbu of Isshinryu Karate India, World Karate Association, which is in epicenter at Kalakshetra Colony, Besanagar, Chennai, Tamil Nadu in India. I like you calling me just as who. Well, this lecture will attempt to impress upon you what karate is truly all about in my view. This is about the philosophy of karate. Karate do in Japanese means empty hand way. The hand is the instrument of the body, the body the instrument of the mind the instrument of the soul, and the soul the instrument of the spirit. The aim of karate do is to develop a synergism of the hand, body, mind, soul and spirit, which manifests itself in the maximum possible controlled release of energy and power. This munificent, bountiful and benevolent efflux or discharge is hugely greater than is commonly suspected and expected. An intriguing, fascinating and riveting quality of karate, which is similar to other systems of self-discipline and self-defense, is the necessity of having to simultaneously develop command of the mind, the body and spirit in a most remarkable way. This outstanding will to excel has to be disciplined and eliminated in its expression through the medium of the body. The body receiving this existential and empirical influx is facilitated in its attainment of the highest being through victory, achievements and stunning successes. If the training and practice of one of the aspects of karate do is neglected for the other, we will fail in the achievement of the maximum and lose valuable derivations from the process. Dear karatekas and sensei, an uneven disciplining will reveal some of the profound processes that are necessary in the release of the human potential through the conscious coordination of the manifold unity of the being. Thus, though these processes are dimly perceived, they feed back to the various levels of the mind and body to facilitate the preceding phases in discipline. The crisis lies precisely in neglecting the basic purpose of the psychophysical training. Although we need the alert body to ward off danger and to conquer attacks from the outside and within, we would be making a sorry bargain if we use the repertoire of physical discipline for the sole purpose of muscle flexing, showing off, or even worse, violent, unprovoked using of skills for the harm of fellow beings. Dear Karatakas and Senseis, the Yoga Sutras of India equally spurn the so-called miraculous mental powers of etc. that may easily become the objective of the lesser yogi who has fallen from his highest prerogative. We can, of course, make use of physical and mental powers for enhancement along partial lines of purposiveness. But it must be remembered that the whole significance and purpose of yoga, as well as of Zen and Karate, lies in the enhancement of the entire person and his spiritual nature. That's the true philosophy of Karate. Though many details of Karate history are still unavailable to us, nearly 5,000 years ago, legend states India had already cultivated mental and physical powers for weaponless defense. The doctrine of Ahimsa is ancient, and it was always allied to the positive use of non-violent warfare for conquering the opponent and even for his conversion to a state of social sanity. These techniques were seemingly being experimented within select communities of Hindus and later on in Buddhist groups in India. Bodhidharma, known as Dharmatashi in Japanese, was a Buddhist monk who studied the Buddhist techniques in India and later went to China, where he taught lay beginner groups and eventually monastic groups at the Shaolin Su, Shorinji in Japanese, a temple in Hunan province. There, Dharmatashi instituted his weaponless self-defense techniques along with Buddhist philosophy in his training. There must have been other monks, contemporaries and those of an early day who were engaged in similar practices based on Taoist and other ancient traditions. But China always insisted that the Indian form of thought control, body control and such other techniques of yogic non-violence were superior to their Chinese counterparts. It will be exciting to know of mutations similar to those that took place, such as the usually accepted adaptive changes that made the original dhyana of India become Chan in China and later Zen in Japan. One feels absolutely sure that these mutational factors always reveal not merely changes in one's order of theory or practice, but changes in the introduction of new elements and actually of transformations as new civilizations and traditions impinged upon the earlier terms, as in the case of Zen. The whole world of karate from that viewpoint was an Okinawan contribution. Even though ideas and techniques originally came from India and China. Now it is the turn of India to perfect the philosophy of Karate Do and make the world understand its true philosophy, definition and meaning that includes Okinawa. Contemporary civilization needs this new and old philosophy of mental power which the individual can deploy for self-protection and mutual protection when violence has intervened. Karate is not entirely based on non-violence, but its clear emphasis is on physical resourcefulness without dependence on weapons. While the hand does not use any weapons, the hands in themselves get transformed into an intimidating armory of lethal weapons. It is the cultivation of empty-handedness, allowing the whole body and the mental energy to be devoted in a single-pointed way. Though operating through different movements towards resisting violence without the intention of destroying the opponent. Rather, the force that the opponent uses in an aggressive way can be turned against him by the karate practitioner. An important distinction has to be drawn at this point between karate, karate jutsu, karate sho, and karate do. Jujutsu karate, whatever its limited importance may be, is a mere technique, like wrestling or boxing, completely divorced from the ontological and ethical philosophy that lies deep in the roots of karate do. Karate sho practitioners are devoted mainly to the spectacular physical skills like breaking wooden boards, tiles, bricks, having smashed rocks on the body and other demonstrative show feats of unbelievable human strength. Karate do, however, is built on the harmonized mind and body, linked up with the creative and regenerative forces of life. Karate do is the way of karate, the way the universe works, and the means of attaining the true meaning of life. We must focus on the positive side of a skill and discipline which is meant to heal, not to destroy or harm society. You all must know that the karate skills acquired by a practitioner can be used in the wrong way, as any skill can be. But you must also know that in that case, a practitioner will pathetically fail in life. The resources of an evil practitioner will become banal if he reduces karate or zen or yoga to a device that lacks the inwardness of a superior training. You must know that self-defense abilities come unconsciously and intuitively after concise, precise, and sustained rational and physical effort. The person of integrity can make the best use of the self-defense and other skillful techniques of karate. We need now, as never before, the spiritual and mental poles which would give us power and relevance to physical selves through the ultimate self-defense called karate. So where the mind becomes the unparalleled lethal weapon to combat, win, and yes, succeed. So much for an introductory philosophy on karate. Welcome to the fascinating realms of the most popular weaponless self-defense art in human history. Till I catch up with you again in the next lecture on karate do, this is Shihan Husseini, respectfully taking a bow. Hoist, and don't forget, I like you calling me just Hu. Doma harigato gozaimasta, sayonara, jai hind, vande mataram.